Now, we would like to show you the tote picking functionality. First, a few words about the functionality. Tote picking has been developed especially for our business-to-consumer webshop customers. And the reason why is that webshops typically have a lot of sales orders, but only with few items on each order. And that means that if you had to pick each order individually, it would be very inefficient. So with the functionality, the solution enables you to pick for multiple customers at the same time and also sort the orders while you're picking. And that means that in the end, the shipping process is quite simple. So a little bit about the concept. The warehouse worker is equipped with a scanner and a picking wagon or trolley with a tote for each order. And a tote in this case can be explained as a temporary bin with a box or a shelf on the picking wagon or trolley. And each tote is labeled with a barcode so it can be registered in Business Central. And in Business Central, we have a filter running, so all the orders that we can see on the scanner will be shipped with the shipping agent DHL. And here's a few examples of how the setup can look like. We have 8 totes on the picking wagon, and also here at the bottom you can see there's an extra tote if the others are full. And in this picture here you can see that the tote here is a shelf with barcodes placed directly on the shelf. Okay, so let's start the picking process. We will go to the pick functionality. And the order that we'll be working on in this session is the pick order number 11. In this session, we have created sales orders for 4 different customers. We have customer number 50, 60, 61, and 62,000. And as you can see here on the screen, we have 2 items for customer number 61,000, the Intense Orange and Intense Mint. And the same goes for customer number 62,000. So you can see the picking route is optimized. So you first will pick the items Intense Orange for all the customers and then go to the other bin where the Intense Mint has been placed. Okay, let's start the process. We'll scan the first item. We will scan the bin where we will take the item. We will scan the tote. And we'll just take tote number 1, but it could be any tote. And then we'll just have to validate the quantity. We'll press the check mark. We'll go to the next item, scan the item number, scan the bin, and scan tote number 2. We'll just take again. We'll scan the bin. We'll scan tote number 3. Scan the bin. And scan tote number 4. And we will press the check mark. So now we can see on the scanner that we have picked the first item for our 4 customers. Let's go to the other bin, number W30001, and start with the next item. This item uses lot tracking, so we'll also have to scan the lot number, but we'll show you in the process. We will scan the item. We'll scan the bin where we will take the item from. We'll scan the lot number. And then the system here suggests that we'll put the item in tote number 3, because this is where we put the first item for customer number 61,000. So we'll just scan tote number 3. We'll go to the next item. Scan the bin where we'll take the item from. Scan the lot number. And then the system suggests that we will take tote number 4. But let's imagine that tote number 4 here is full. Then we can just take a new tote. Let me just show you how that works. We'll have tote number 5. And the system says that we have a new tote scan. Do we want to use this? I'll say yes. And accept the quantity by pressing the check mark. And then we're ready to post the order. I'll say yes. And the order posted successfully. and the order disappeared from the mobile device. So that was the tote picking functionality. The next step in the process is for the warehouse worker to go with the picking wagon to the shipping zone in the warehouse, and then the shipping personnel will handle the shipping process.